are connected to high acidity caused by a diet which is rich in animal foods and not in vegetables. Now, this food which is rich in animal products, it is mainly acidic, it's considered as acidic food. So these women were accumulating acidic waste and having an acidic pH in their body. This is why, to compensate for the pH imbalance, the compensation was taken from the calcium ion in order to compensate for the loss of the pH. There is a Japanese professor also discovered that most allergies were due to acidification of body condition and is also related to consuming too much meat and sugar. He was stating that in every allergy case, the patient's antioxidant minerals are excessively low, which in turn lowered the body resistance significantly. Now, when we have an increase in alkaline pH, increase in the pH, the body is rich in reducing agents. So this scientist was stating that the body becomes overly sensitive and was developing allergy easily due to the acidic conditions which was noted in the body.
2 minutes, please.
Okay. Now, pH and stress, we know that cortisol also leads to increase in the metabolism, leads to also acidic accumulation. What to do, some refreshment for water facts. We need to drink 2-3 liters of good quality water. We usually drink around we lose about 100.5 liters a day from sweat and urine. Now, most of us, we do not drink enough water simply because water drinking is hard. Now, the water which is usually hard to drink, it is acidic water because there is a kind of hardness in it and bitterness in its taste. So this is one of the factors why we do not drink enough water, why we are not kept hydrated most of the time. There's also a mistake in the explanation of the thirst. We usually mistaken the thirst by hunger and we overeat. This leads to overweight also. These are also related to water facts that most of us are familiar with. There is, in the United States, cardiovascular disease accounts for more than one half of the approximate 2 million deaths occurring each year. A doctor of medicine also was stating in one of his papers that if an optimal conditions of the water is kept and maintained in the United States, this percentage would be reduced by a very big amount. Now, alkaline water has a pH of 8 and 10. So it will have 100 times excess oxygen. It will have 100 times reducing abilities than the neutral water. Some scientists suggest, and these are all studies, controversial studies, that such alkaline water might be able to fight cancer. A study was also done in a symposium on man and his environment, health and disease. It stated that when preparing food for inpatients using alkaline water and giving them alkaline water, they noticed a decline in uric acid levels. Patients with gout, they noticed improvement in liver functions with hepatic disease patients. Improvement in gastrointestinal ulcers, also improvement in hypertension and hypertension, and improvement in allergic disorders such as asthma, urticaria, rhinitis, and atopic dermatitis. There was also improvement in other medical diseases and conditions. So to hydrate the body optimally, it's important to drink alkaline and mineral-rich water. The alkaline water will help in neutralizing the acid and it will remove the toxins from the body. So the pH should be somewhere around 8 and 9. A study was done by Dr. Babars in pH, while in the northeastern part of the country has an alkaline pH 8.4. As we go south, the pH is decreasing. That is due to the increase in the sulfur amount in the rocks, which leads to increase in the decrease in the pH of the alkaline water. Now, many claims have been raised towards the profits and the benefits of alkaline and natural food and alkaline foods. However, not much studies has been done on this field. I believe that extensive research should be done on not alternative medicine, on maintaining healthy life and drinking healthy water. Knowing what is best to do in order to assist the doctors in minimizing the medical conditions and cases they all face. Thank you all.
Thank you for your informative talk. And the floor is open for a couple of questions. Yes.
Excellent presentation. You mentioned one, sorry, aspartame. Aspartame is a fructose. The fructose which forms all our drinks, which is all four of them. On soft drink is from corn syrup. This is a fructose. This means that it's acidic.
Yes.
And this is why you are going to osteoporosis and you correlated to cancer, to osteoporosis, to
everything. Yes. I just wanted to mention regarding aspartame, also I once read a paper, I don't know how true it was, that it leads to symptoms which mimics multiple sclerosis symptoms also. So it has adverse effects that we all should be aware of.
Yes, please.
The effect of the food on the pH of the blood, because we know the pH of blood is strictly controlled by microbial buffer.
Yes.
So I don't know whether you have studies indicating that food affects the blood pH or not.
Now, I was, as I explained, it is not the direct effect of the pH change in the blood. When there is a slight change, the body compensates for that change by taking the minerals in order to keep the buffer, the buffering constant in the blood. So it is not actually the damage which is done on the blood, it's the damage which is done on the other organs, on the bones, which is taking the minerals in order to keeping that buffering system of the blood constant. No, no, this is why I was asking, we need to have more thorough studies in order to have scientific papers which are documented and read the documentation regarding these topics.
And I don't think the pH of the saliva and the urine will reflect on the status of the pH of the blood.
It will not reflect on the status of the pH of the blood is usually kept constant. However, it will reflect on the status of the wastes we are taking. And now, the pH, we all know that the pH of the urine it is a very big range, you know. But we need to do a study to see whether the effect of alkaline water and alkaline food is truly affecting this range by keeping it closer to the alkaline range or not.
With this talk, we come to the end of our first session. On behalf of the organizing committee, we would like to thank you all for your kind attendance and patience. I think you can enjoy a break now. Thank you.
να πεις αυτό.